Hi, good morning, good afternoon, everyone who is joining this webinar. This is Amit Kumar and I'm glad to welcome you to this webinar where we'll be talking about how to reimagine the Oracle Cloud Test Automation with insights into your process and the key business analytics. So today we'll be talking about this and you'll see how our solution enables this. Before we start on the webinar, some housekeeping rules. So like any other webinar, the audience lines are on mute, but we would like to hear your questions, comments as we do the presentation and the demo. So please feel free to send in your opinions and questions. Also, the session is being recorded. So at the end, we will be posting the link to this recording. So if you want to review any section or even share with your colleagues, you will be able to do that. Also, we'll be sharing some key artifacts to the session participants. So feel free to check in for that and you can download this strategy document. So that will be something to look forward to in addition to the demo recording. Just to go through the agenda, we'll be talking about what is this market in terms of automation on Oracle Cloud. Then talking about the change imperative use cases, followed with the transformation imperative, and then seeing it how our solution addresses these things and the business benefits it brings. After that, we'll have a quick demo. And in the end, we will take up all the questions which you would have input there on the question panel, and we will address that one by one. Today with me is Dimpy, and she is going to take us through this demo today. So Dimpy, over to you.
Thank you, Amit, and thank you so much everyone for joining in the session today, and I'll be taking you through this demonstration now. So as we see that the agenda holds up what we have in store for the market, and this is where we are going to start as well, because we are reimagining Oracle Cloud Test Automation from the strategic standpoint, and we are saying that how these analytics or business analytics or process analytics would help change the impact how market is seeing today is something that we are going to look at. So the market today has two sides to it. One, the customer expectations, and second is the productivity that we are receiving. So basically something that we expect and something that is in the reality. So on the left is the customer expectations, where we are always expected to provide instant gratification, a good quality experience, transparency and authenticity. But in reality, the part that we are seeing in reality for different ERP applications, and specifically for Oracle Cloud, if we say where things are changing in absolutely at multi-fold speed, as soon as it has moved to cloud, and with different ERP solutions and offerings across different domains running at one particular time, it is really difficult for organizations achieving that part. We could see at the legacy application case that there were changes in about like 5 years or 10 years, and they would migrate very, very slowly, and the digital transformation part was really, really slow. And at that time, whatever productivity we were receiving is not at all acceptable because it's not keeping pace with the development. And this is where the productivity comes into picture. We're just going about, testing the part that's a positive workflow, or just going about testing whatever processes we are working on in a critical stage, and that's it. This is the reality of the time, where it's not matching the speed of digital transformation, where key users are very, very expensive, and we always have to go into a hypercare mode in order to address those changes or implementations or cloning of different instances, or all of those issues that we see as part of our ERP applications, or the production risk, right? We are always into the risk when we are receiving the production. Not necessarily we are receiving the issues up front, but there could be issues that people are following up in weeks later, where the managers who are signing off are not confident about releasing at a particular production or test coverage that it should be. So test coverage, as we see and take up from this slide, is one of the key areas. Risk is one of the key areas, and the key user's time is one of the key areas that we need to focus on in order to achieve the speed of digital transformation where the development is happening at this particular time. And inadvertently, everything is leading to continuous development and continuous testing part, which we need to focus on very, very keenly. And that is exactly what is kind of a stage setting for this particular presentation as well. And we as an organization wanted to address this, that it was very, very relevant for people to look at how the analytics can help us achieve that, how we can have an improvement index and analyze that. From here, we need to work backwards and understand our processes, understand that there needs to be a way, or there needs to be a utility or a platform that should help us constantly telling us that this is something that should be taken care of in terms of improvement or a test coverage index or a risk index, and an end-to-end management visibility where you can learn at every stage where your transformation is heading, and you can take key steps at that particular point. So heading from this point, let me take you to the use cases that are absolutely change imperatives in the market today. One of them is periodic cloud updates. So when it comes to, and why we have not mentioned only quarterly updates for Oracle Cloud, because there are many of them. There are exceptionals updates that are coming in, there are refreshes that are coming in, there are quarterly updates that are coming in. And even if we do not talk about these forced updates, we are looking at constant configuration changes as part of our agile lifecycle. And I think it's out there in the market, and everybody is talking about it, that we only say about agile lifecycle, but inadvertently everybody is working in a waterfall methodology, and we need to change that again in order to do a continuous development and testing at the same time. Migration to cloud, most of us know that we'll have to do it before 23 and 25 respectively in order to move to Oracle Cloud, because the support for many of the legacy application and their versions are stopping. And that's where the support in terms of what should be my migration strategy be. How should I migrate from my Oracle Cloud instance to, the legacy instance to Oracle Cloud. And many of us fear that, because of obviously if we would be able to test it properly in order to have a seamless production release. So that's another use case. And again, the third one is configuration change in any part of application ecosystem. So when we do talk about the Oracle Cloud as a silo application, yes, there are multiple configuration changes happening. And we could be covering that as part of our tests. If not 100%, there could be some percentage of that coming in. But most often than not, we do miss out on the end-to-end applications that are connected to it, either different other packaged applications or custom applications or utilities or Excels in other cases, or APIs or databases. And we need to see those configuration changes and incorporate that as part of our businesses and analytics as well, in order to analyze at an end-to-end stage what's happening in our application at one particular time. So how do we successfully execute this change? Again, analytics are important for instant feedback to understand what is the criticality happening in that particular industry. What are we using at that particular point more, so we understand that where exactly is the improvement required. Visualization, advanced visualization and discovery. And when we mean or say these things, we mean that the implementation time or, you know, the configurations that we are making into the applications not necessarily is translated into any kind of document. It's mostly in the business users' minds. And in order to have that discovery upfront on the platform, it's really, you know, a lot of time saved there. And that discovery helps us to implement it faster and then give it that kind of a scale, so we can have like an improvement index also at a later stage. So our major KPIs are covered, and then you have a cross-platform view of your ongoing processes as well. And once this successful execution of change has happened, we could see that the transformation imperative is not so far away. So the change is obviously hard when the organizations work in silos. So we need to isolate those limits. We need to have the availability of exact metrics, and we can't do that when the applications are not connected together. But now when we're seeing that the businesses are transforming, we can see that there has to be more and more efficient collaboration, and a customer focused KPI transformation journey will only help people achieve that. So it's more like this is where we are heading, right? So we are heading towards the business transformation, and that's where we need the focused KPI driven transformations to for people to understand what the transformation requires. So this is where we come in as OpKey and another platform of OpKey, which is being introduced, which is test mining. And that's where the solution is really helping, and proposing customers help and achieve autonomous tests in no time, because the processes are mined from the application's instance, in this case Oracle Cloud, in order to reduce the test implementation time. There are real-time recommendation of test cases that are happening based on the configurations of that particular instance, which means that if you have, say, five organizations unit configured, so you have the recommendation of test based on that, because necessarily you might have, say, receivables configured for one organization and not configured for the other one. So the recommendation will be very, very personalized based on the organizations and based on the configurations that you have been using as part of your instance. So this is the configuration mining part, and combined these two becomes the AI powered test mining engine that automatically configures your tests with the data and the processes that it should execute based on the blueprint of the application, and then executes it upfront. So you'll have one particular platform, one particular screen where you can execute all of these things in one case, and helping you achieve a greater test coverage index, a reduction in risk coverage, and an absolute efficient analytics for the improvement index of different processes that are running in your organization and one particular point. So you can have a look at this one of the examples here, where there is a process that's working across a organization at different activities are happening. So this is one of the process maps that you could be using in your organization, and whatever test flows are being worked upon, those test cases and processes are first of all mapped and then created as part of test cases, real test cases with the configuration data that is part of the organization in real time. And you can execute, you can select your variant and execute your tests from that particular point. At the end, what are we achieving in terms of business benefits? A key area for all of us to understand at the end, we want to achieve those business benefits in order to achieve that particular reduction in effort. This is what we are striving for towards the end of either one-time implementations or changes or releases. And that's where we as a solution are also focused on. So a quick blueprint of your test processes immediately saves you time in terms of the test implementation. So it takes away from the business user's time, where we say that, okay, we would like to have the payables business user available for us in order to explain what all processes are working for payroll or payables at that particular point, or HR for that particular point, or payroll for that particular organization. So we want to know those processes in order to build them where it's an absolute autonomous process, also providing you an efficiency analytics, telling you that this is the improvement area that you should be focusing on. So it's one step ahead. Generation of those test cases out of the process map that you've just seen in the previous slide is another key area. So this is what we need to test as part of your test cases. So you have your feature tests cycle, your regression test cycle created for you automatically with the configuration data that you would be using it to execute. So that generation is automatic. Then you have an autonomous self-configuring engine. And when we say that, it just means that A, you have the test cases that will have the relevant test data set for which is essentially the configurations, and also in different combinations. So it could be different types getting combined with different organization units and then creating multiple combinations, and rather than just executing one positive business workflow. Again, all helping that increase the test coverage index and by over 90% reduction in the risk of coverage. So we have a recommendation that tells you that if you want to, so this is the process map that we have received, and if you want to reduce your risk, you might have to look at the recommendations. This is beyond the test cases that you are executing, and if you suggest that, the coverage will automatically increase by OpKey, and that's, you know, increases your coverage by over 60 to 70%. And then there's a gap analysis. So this is another analytics that focuses on the process efficiency, that this is a gap that we are seeing as part of the industry model. So for example, if you're a financial organization, or if you're a pharma organization, or if you're a aeronautics organization, based on that, there could be certain processes that are kind of mandatory or critical or important in terms of priority. So you might be executing that as well. So that gap helps you analyze those efficiency analytics as well. So this was something in terms of slides that we wanted to take you through. And again, as Amit mentioned, we'd be looking forward to any questions that you guys would have. So please drop in your questions at the panel, and I'll be taking them through along with Amit towards the Q&A session. But now we'll move to a quick round of demo where you can see some of these things in action and visualize for yourself. So this is the test mining platform by OpKey. This is a new platform that is coming up for the customers. And if you can see, there are multiple processes to start your session with, along with Oracle. So there is Salesforce, SAP, composable processes where you know, different processes or applications can be combined together. There are custom processes that can be created, not necessarily only the packaged applications or the ERP applications, that could be combined in order to create that process map. Looking at Oracle, you can see there are different sort of processes that are part of Oracle Cloud are mentioned here, which can be selected. It completely takes on the complete territory of Oracle Cloud. So no, it's kind of like all the processes of Oracle Cloud are combined and available for users. As an example, we'd be looking at order to cash. So when we start the process, there are a couple of steps that we need to go through in order to have those analytics in the form of the process map and the test analytics for the customer to be available. The first step is the data extraction, where the test mining platform goes into the application instance automatically and gets in the data and different events and activities from the instance, followed by a process engine that translates that data into actual process maps that is running at one particular point in your organization as well. So as I move forward, and we enter these details, which is like environment connection details, because it connects to the Oracle Cloud instance at that particular point. The analytics are now created. And if you look at one of the other analytics, it will tell you that for order to cash cycle, this is the analytics that we are looking at. So this is the overall analytics. At one particular point, the organization is running these activities and applications differently. There are different activities that is happening. So for example, the change confirmed goods issue has happened one time, confirmed quantities happened two times, or sales order item is created 24 times. So whatever activities have happened and the number of times will only help us achieve those efficiency analytics towards the end. And then based on these process maps, there are different variants and test cases recorded, and the right panel calculates that. There are different cases and activities that are captured here. As we move forward, it takes us from process analytics to test analytics. And there are other efficiency analytics that are also part of it, and I'll talk about it in the later part of the demo. So you can see these different test cases that are starting up. You can also have a view at the number of items at that particular point used and the volume that is being worked upon in the organization, only to tell you the efficiency analytics towards the end. Now, once this part is taken by, I think the second step that is remaining is, what is the set of test data, or how will my, this process map is going to be converted into test cases? So OpKey now connects to the accelerator library that it has already created. So it's a pre-built accelerator library with OpKey already for Oracle Cloud across different modules. So it extends to the O2C cycles or the P2P or plan to produce or record to report and all the processes that are also available as part of Oracle Cloud. So that's already there. So those processes are in here in terms of the product overview. You can see here in the left panel, the entire product and different pre-built test cases. Now this process map connects to the accelerator library and creates automatic test cases for you. So now those test cases are created automatically. And not only that, so if the right panel, so these test cases are now called up from the accelerator, accelerator library that we just saw. And on the right, you have different test cases now listed down based on this process map that we were looking at that are now created. And based on the variant is something that the organization is already using. And OpKey recommended are the ones that OpKey recommends that for that particular process, in this case, O2C or order to cash, that should be executed by the organizations, which is essentially not being used by the organization at that point. So those are the recommendations. And that helps us achieve the coverage that we want to achieve in an extensible manner. Based on variants will be the one that we will be executing as part of the organization's processes that are being used. Having said that, we can now have the data. The data is now part of the customer to edit the information, because it will be available automatically from OpKey. Every set of test case will have the test data automatically feed in, and that will come from the self-configuring engine. So when we are mining the data from the application, we are not only getting the order to cash cycle, we are also getting the data in a self-configuring manner. So this is how the data will be fed to every single test case across different scenarios and different data combinations. And that's the self-configuring engine attached to the test mining engine. Once the data part is done and the test cases are ready, the only part that is left is to execute the test case. So the execution is now started. We just hit the play button, and this particular test case is now available. You can see the live execution here on the left panel at the downside of the grid. And then on the right side, you can have the live steps for you in order to view what's happening at that particular point. And then we start the execution and go to the execution for OpKey. So the execution is now happening at the application stage. So the execution is now complete, and as soon as the execution is complete, we have the results with us. The results will be available on the platform as well, which is getting integrated to this one. The results will look in this particular way, where you have the status information, the test case information, the total time, and whatever time that test case has passed through across different steps and different stages, with snapshots at every level of the test case. Now, since it does, so we have the snapshots here. So you can have the snapshots at every level or the failed level. So that's up to the choice of the user. And along with that, you have efficiency analytics for the across processes. So we're looking at the improvement index towards the later stage where we see that the processes have to go through a certain process improvement in order to have the test mining or the analytics work for them, that this is the way that it should be, include the cycle time or the change rate or the price changes or the on-time delivery, anything that you're doing as part of the order to cash cycle is part of the process efficiency and analytics that we'll work on. So again, I think this was all for the demonstration. I'll now move back to the slides. And Amit, we can now look at the questions that the attendees might have.
Okay, thank you, Dimpy, for the presentation and the demo. So the first question is, when you talk about the test analytics, so what is included in the test analytics?
Well, the test analytics include the recommended test case, the test case based on the variance that the customer is using, the test coverage index, the risk coverage index. We can also increase the coverage and reduce the risk, and you can look at the test coverage being exceeded in terms of the recommendation. So yeah, and some of the data combinations that are part of those test cases that could be chosen as part of the test analytics. So yeah, these four.
And for the process efficiency analytics, are these the same thing or that's another set of?
That's absolutely separate. So for the process efficiency, we'll be focusing on the processes that we have gone by in terms of the instance, right? So it would be more towards, so for example, order to cash would include some of the examples like cycle time or change rate or price change or on-time delivery or order rejections, you know, what has happened across that particular complete order to cash cycle in terms of shipping, picking, receiving, invoicing or payment. And for example, if I talk about procure to pay, it would include maverick buying or processing time, or again, on-time delivery or the first time right information, so that we can have those efficiency analytics in order to improve those processes for the benchmarks that we have in the market today. So Opki would be analyzing that and telling you that based on the benchmarks, this is the improvement analytics that you are looking at, and this is where we should head now.
Okay. So the next question is, in terms of test mining, is data also included as part of this, what you create as an output, or data has to be entered separately?
Well, data has two sides to it. So as we do the configuration mining as part of the test mining already, so we have the data sets with us, which would be fed to the test cases automatically. So that's kind of a self-configuring thing. But having said that, those test cases can be modified and the data can be edited in order to use them. So the customers do have the flexibility to modify those test data the way they want to do it. So to answer your question, both the options are available.
And coming back to the question earlier on the test analytics, so are these test analytics for the module wise or is it for the whole thing? How do you give that output?
So the test analytics is broken down essentially in a standard way how Oracle Cloud works. So it could be module wise, but we have taken the route of processes. So it could be more process oriented, and that kind of covers the whole sort of territory. So for example, Oracle Cloud essentially in its own ERP space has about 12 to 15 processes, and that comprises of everything. So whether it is O2C, that covers the 70% of order management or payables, receivables, or the invoice to cash or plan to produce, record to report, so hire to retire, and all of those processes will essentially cover all the modules as well. So it would cover a fixed asset and it would cover a payables and a receivables when we go through them. So it's kind of a same thing, but the route that we have is more process oriented.
Okay. So one of the next question is that what is recommended when this all this analytics is done, right? So do we have to necessarily execute all those things, or can we choose from that?
No, you can absolutely choose from the recommendations. So recommendations is only for the benefit of customers who want to extend those test coverage index. So for example, I have a certain set of variants which is like 20 test cases, and I just want to execute them. But they have a choice based on their industry, that based on the financial industry, you know, this is the suggested test cases. So there should be these 50 test cases that should be executed, and their risk would be say 50% if they do not execute that. And if say they want to reduce the risk say to 30%, the coverage will increase to another 10 test cases. So it's only about their choice. Whatever risk they choose, based on that, they can increase the test coverage and execute that. If they do not want to select the gap analysis and the recommended test cases, absolutely fine. They can go ahead with the variance that they have that has automatically created, and then execute from that particular point. So it's more towards customer's choice.
Actually, the next question is about gap analysis. So can you expand a little bit more on what all is included in gap analysis, and how do customers actually use it to their benefit?
Sure. So the gap analysis really extends to something which is called as models. You know, if I really want to extend this particular question and answer anybody who has asked this question, is that the gap analysis talks about a comparison between a standard stuff and something that you have it in reality. So it's more like a comparison between the two, and where we specify a standard is something that we as a solution we have our proprietary and we have our expertise in, that we have some standard models created for across different domains and processes. And maybe for Oracle Order2Cash, we might have say 10 different models across financials or pharma or manufacturing units or project system units or so on and so forth. So we have different models, and based on whatever industry you are part of or the customer is part of, it will do a comparative analysis, and then it will give you those recommendations that these are the test cases that you are using at this point, and these are the test cases that OpKey recommends you to have it. So essentially it will include these two things, the test coverage, the risk index, and the test cases, all of that, it will include that, but it is more like a comparative analysis between the standard and the real map that we have received from the Oracle instance.
Okay. I think that's all I had questions. Dimpio, again, over to you if you want to summarize today's webinar before we close.
No, I think this is all I had as well, but I think in order to summarize, I just want to tell or take this opportunity to talk to our attendees and people who have taken out the time to join us, is to say that the process analytics and the business analytics and combined testing as a platform is a very, very important area. It doesn't matter how much we have developed, if it has not gone to the testing stage successfully and it has not passed the testing stage successfully in order to reach the production. Most often than not, no life cycle is complete without the, you know, testing go ahead and sign off. And analytics as a, you know, AI part and digital transformation stage, and wherever we are in the market or day and age today, it plays a very important role. You know, we need data to analyze what should be the logical next step. And that is exactly what we are also doing as part of our platform. We were a ERP platform with different differentiators and solutions like the accelerator or the change impact analysis or the self-configuring engine, but now are providing the users to or taking it ahead, one step ahead or a leap ahead with these process and business analytics, only to help our customers achieve that that step notch of business benefits that they require in order to keep pace with the development that's happening in the market. And this is all we are focusing on. And again, thank you so much, everyone, for joining in the session today. Thank you very much.
Yeah, so thanks, Timpi, for the nice presentation, nice, concise. So thank you for that. And I look forward to people reaching out to the OpKey team so that we can look at your challenges and your specific issues, questions. So feel free to reach out to us. The information how to reach out is given here. And looking forward to talking to all of you. Thank you so much. With this, we'll close the webinar today.
Thank you, everyone.